Namaskaram. Let's start with lecture 3 of GST. In this lecture, we are going to discuss, first we will take some revision whatever things we have discussed till now. And major part of today's lecture is on exemptions. Okay, we have to discuss exemptions and we have to discuss questions from your study note 2. Okay, module, your institute module wise. So, we started GST, which act we are into? CGST Act 2070. Alright, in this act section 1 we have already discussed. Section 1 is extent of the law, extent and commencement of the law. What is extent and commencement of the law? So GST extends to whole of India including Jammu and Kashmir, and commencement wise it is commenced on 1st July 2017, but for Jammu and Kashmir it was 8th July 2017, right? Section 2 is about definition. Section 2 is about what? Definition. There are two types of definition that we will all usually discuss. Okay, inclusive definition and exhaustive definition. Inclusive definition and exhaustive definition. Inclusive definition will start with the word includes. Hello, inclusive definition will start with the word includes, and then exhaustive definition will start with the word means. Whenever definition start with the word means, it is very strict definition. You cannot dilute the meaning of definition. Whenever definition start with the word includes, it is like overall, like supply definition was inclusive definition. Alright, so it's not that hard and fast definition. It's an inclusive reasonable definition. Some more item will come into that. Yes or no? Yes. Alright, so this is what definition. Section 2, lot of definition we have already discussed. Definition of goods, definition of taxable person, definition of service. Alright, and wherever required, we will jump to the definition and we will discuss the definition. Okay. Section 3, 4, 5, 6. Section 3, 4, 5, 6. I haven't discussed with you technically because this is power of authorities. Power of authority. Power and appointment of authorities. Okay. Not that required for our exam, but whenever we'll get time, we'll just look into these things. But these sections are not that relevant for us. Am I clear? Section 1 is relevant, section 2 is relevant, section 3, 4, 5, 6, power of authorities, you can remember just for the time being. Section 7, anybody? Section 7, what is section 7? Definition of supply. And why supply is important? Because supply is a taxable event. Supply is a taxable event in law. Section 7 we have discussed yesterday. Alright. Section 7 is divided into three main section. Section 7.1, Section 7.1A and Section 7.2. Am I clear? Section 7.1 is further divided into, here it is written supply includes. Supply includes. Yes, yes or no? Supply includes. Supply includes three part. 7.1A, 7.1B and 7.1C. So this you should remember. Okay. 7.1A is the core. Okay. It says supply includes all form of supply, not any particular form. Supply includes all form of supply of goods or service or both. Goods, service or both. Okay. What is the definition of goods? No. Section 2 clause 52. Section 2 clause 52. Goods means goods includes and goods excludes. Any kind of movable property, it includes actionable claim, growing crops, grass, things attached and forming part of land, that language, and then excludes two items, money and security. The moment you are done with the definition of goods, we will also discuss definition of service in this three form. Service is defined in section 2 clause 102. Service means anything other than goods. It includes three activities: use of money, conversion of money from one form to another, from one currency to another, from one denomination to another, right? And then lastly, facilitating or arranging transaction in securities. And it excludes two items, money and security. So till now we have understood two items are not taxable. Money and security per se is not taxable in our GST law. Am I clear? So that is this thing. 7.1A, supply, all form of supply such as transfer, sale, transfer, barter, exchange, lease, license, rental, disposal. Yes or no? Any form, not specific form. By a person, obviously it has to be done by a Person and person means individual, HUF, AOP, BOI, company, firm, LLP, even local authority. So many people are there as a person. Am I clear? Alright. For a consideration. For a consideration. Definition of consideration we will discuss today. For a consideration. And then the next important definition part of that particular clause was, okay, for a consideration in the course or furtherance of business. Okay. For a consideration and in the course or furtherance of business. So what I said yesterday, in clause 7.1a, if you wanted to cover in clause 7.1a, then you have to satisfy minimum two condition, and that is business condition and consideration condition. Then only your activity will be called as supply. This is the core of GST law. Am I clear? Yeah. Second, 7.1b says, okay, sometime business will not be there, but consideration has to be there. Business is not there, but consideration will be there, and this is applicable only in case of importation of service. Importation of service for a consideration. Importation of service for a consideration, whether or not in the course or furtherance of business. This is the language given under section 7.1b. Yes or no? Alright. Importation of service for a consideration, whether or not in the course or furtherance of business. What is there in 7.1c? 7.1c says, sir, B has to be there, C will not be there. That means certain activities which are done without charging any consideration. Without charging consideration, no consideration, still there will be GST charge on that. Alright. Sir, it is known as the deemed supply. It is known as? It is not actual supply. This is deemed supply. And deemed supply has to be written in schedule 1. I told you logic yesterday. Okay, because we cannot have unlimited list, so we must have limited list for that. Schedule 1 gives 4 paras, para 1, para 2, para 3, para 4. Only 4 activities can be treated as a supply, even if it is done without consideration. Am I clear? But business should be there. It has to be in business nature. And I give you example then, if business is also not there and consideration is also not there, both are not there, then that activity is not a supply. That activity is not a supply, and something which is not a supply cannot be taxed. Therefore, the love and care and food given by your mother and father is not taxable, because it is done without consideration and not in the course of business. Am I clear? Yeah. So this is how you need to understand. So to become supply, either you have to satisfy 7.1a or 7.1b or 7.1c. 7.1a is the core which talks about business plus consideration. 7.1b talks about importation of service. Importation of service. Alright. 7.1c talks about supply without consideration. Only 4 activities. Those activities we will discuss in schedule 1 today. Alright. Section 7.1a talks about schedule 2. Section 7.1a talks about schedule 2. Schedule 2 talks about these activities which are both, okay, which are both. And sometimes there is a confusion, alright, that whether it is a supply of goods or supply of service. That confusion will be clarified by section 7.1a schedule. Arjun, can you pause this?